Hello student, welcome to digital classes. This video is for class 8. Subject is science and this is the continue of the chapter number 8, cell structure and functions. This is the second part of this chapter. In this chapter, I am going to tell you about organelles, cell organelles, some other organelles. Like lysosome, centrosome, plastids, etc. Then what is the difference between plant cell and animal cell? In this chapter, cell structure and function, in the previous video I told or I explained about instrument called microscope, who discovered cell, the number of cell, size of the cell, cell structure and functions like cell membrane, cytoplasm, function of nucleus, function of cell membrane, prokaryotic cell and eukaryotic cell. Let us start this chapter with an activity that is given in your book. That is the activity number 2, to observe the human cheek epithelial cell. Material required: slide, cover slip, scalpel or a thin plastic shirt collar bone, watch glass. Procedure: wash thoroughly the scalpel or a thin plastic shirt collar bone, scrape gently the inner surface your cheek inside the mouth with the help of a scalpel. Place that scraping on a clean slide. Put a drop of water on the scraping and spread it on the slide with the help of needle. Cover it with a cover slip and observe the cheek epithelial cell under the microscope. Place another sample of scraping on another glass slide. Spread it with the help of a needle and place a drop of methyl blue over it. After about 2 minutes, remove the excess methyl blue and place a drop of glycerin on the stained scraping. Place a cover slip on the scraping and press it gently. Observe the strained cheek epithelial cell under the microscope. The nucleus of the cell is strained dark blue. Observation: from the observation, it is found that the human cheek epithelial cell are irregular shape and has a thin cell membrane. Each cell has a nucleus at the center and there is no cell wall. When your school will open, I will show this in the lab. Now the cell wall. This is basically in plant cell, not in human cell. It is the outer to cell membrane and it is dead and freely permeable. All substance can pass through it. It is thick layer and present only in the cell of plants. Cell wall is made up of cellulose, but in fungus cell is made up of chitin. In addition to the cell wall, cell membrane is also required by the plants for protection against various temperature, variation in temperature, high wind speed, atmospheric moisture. The plant cell and the bacteria also have an outer wall surrounding the cell membrane. This outer wall is called cell wall. The cell wall is made up of stiff material called cellulose. The cell wall in plants surround the cell provide protection against temperature variation, high speed wind and atmospheric pressure also. Now the function of cell wall. It provides mechanical support to the cell. It allows all the substance to pass through it. It maintains the shape of a cell. Everyone can draw plant cell in their classwork copy. There are three type of plastids which are as follows. Leucoplast, it is colorless. Chromoplast, the chromoplast is a colorful plastid. And third is chloroplast. The chloroplast is the green colored. It is known as the kitchen of the cell because it helps plant to make food. In order to make food, plant need chlorophyll which is present in chloroplast. Chloroplast is helpful in photosynthesis. Chloroplast is double membrane organelle containing stoma and sagged lamella called grana. Grana contain green pigment chlorophyll that help in photosynthesis. These are the plant organelles, and maybe this is not given in the book, so you have to write while watching this video. Now the function of plastids. Chloroplast is helpful in photosynthesis. Leucoplast is helpful in store food and fat, etc. Chromoplast is a colored and imparts color of flower and fruits. It means chromoplast give color to the flower and fruit. Now the organelles present in animal cell. First is mitochondria. It is known as powerhouse of the cell. It is rod shaped double membrane. Its outer membrane is porous. Its inner membrane is folded in order to cristae and contain small bodies, exosomes. The fluid which is present in mitochondria is called as matrix. Fluid contains DNA, genetic material and rhizosomes. It is present in plant as well as animal also. What is the name of the organelle which has its own genetic material, DNA? Answer is mitochondria. Now the function of mitochondria. In mitochondria, breakdown of food occurs and produces energy in chemical form and stored in the form of ATP, adenosine triphosphate. So that is why the mitochondria is called a powerhouse of the cell. Now the question arises, what is called as powerhouse? Explain. Mitochondria is known as powerhouse of the cell because breakdown of food occur in it. It produces energy in chemical form and that is ATP. This ATP is useful in doing various activities. ATP is known as the currency of the cell. Now vacuoles. It is fluid-filled membrane. It is present in plant. In plant cell, vacuoles are large and permanent. The outer membrane of the plant cell is called as tonoplast and filled with fluid cell sap. There are chances that they may be present in animal, but their size is very small and are temporary. Vacuoles are present in animal and are used for storage purposes. Function of vacuoles. It provide turgidity and rigidity. They are useful in storing substances. The sac-like structure present in the cytoplasm are called vacuole. The vacuole in plant cell are large. In animal cell, vacuole are less frequently and are smaller in size. Vacuoles store soluble food, waste and secretion of all the cell dissolve in water as cell sap. This is a little bit extra. Endoplasmic reticulum, you may read this about in 9th or 10th class. It is a membranous network or irregular network of membrane enclosing fluids in its cavity. Endoplasmic reticulum are of two types. Rough endoplasmic reticulum, RER, smooth endoplasmic reticulum, SER. Rough endoplasmic reticulum, rhizosomes are attached, and in smooth, rhizosomes are not attached. The function of endoplasmic reticulum. Smooth endoplasmic reticulum is helpful in fats and lipid synthesis. Endoplasmic reticulum forms skeleton framework of the cell, like bones and muscles make our body framework. Similar, ER forms the framework of the cell. Rough endoplasmic reticulum has rhizosomes and helpful in protein synthesis. RER provide the site for protein synthesis. Smooth endoplasmic reticulum is helpful in detoxification. Endoplasmic reticulum is helpful in the formation of membrane of cells also. Now Golgi apparatus. These are stacked membranes or flattened cystin having fluid filled vesicles. In plant cell, it is called as dicotysomes. Function of Golgi apparatus. They secrete packages and dispatch the cellular secretion. They are helpful in the formation of cell membrane. Lysosomes. These are membrane bounded vesicles containing powerful digestive enzyme. The function of lysosomes. They destroy foreign material. They remove the component which are worn out. They act as suicidal bag, as they can even eat up their own cell if it is get damaged. It means when the cell get damaged, the lysosome burst and decompose that cell. Now the difference between animal and plant cell. In plant cell, a plant cell is usually larger in size, whereas an animal cell is comparatively smaller in size. It is enclosed by a rigid cellulose cell wall in addition to plasma membrane. In animal cell, it is enclosed by a thin flexible plasma membrane only. In plant cell, it cannot be changed its shape, but in animal cell, an animal cell can often change its shapes. Plastid. In plant cell, it is present. Plant cell exposed to sunlight contain chloroplast, whereas plastid are usually absent in animal cell. A mature plant cell contain a large central vacuole, but in animal cell it is small in size or sometime temporary. In nucleus lies on one side in the peripheral cytoplasm. In animal cell, nucleus usually lies in the center. Centrioles are usually absent except in motile cell of lower plants. Centrioles are particularly present in animal cell. Lysosomes are rare in plant cell, whereas liposomes are always present in animal cell. Glyoxysomes may be present, but it is absent in animal cell. Now the tight junctions are desmosomes and lagged. Tight junctions are desmosomes are present between cell. Reserve food is generally in the form of starch. Reserve food is usually glycogen in animal cell, basically stored as fat. Plant cells synthesize all amino acid, coenzymes and vitamin required by them. Animal cell cannot synthesize all the amino acid, coenzymes and vitamins required by them. In plant cell, spindles form during cell division in anastel, that is without ancestor of opposite pole. In animal cell, spindle form during cell division is amphiestrel, that is has an ester at each pole. Cytokinesis. occur by cell plate method. Cytokinesis occur by construction or furrowing an animal cell. Plant cell does not burst if placed in hypertonic solution due to the presence of the cell wall. Animal cell lacking contractile vacuole usually burst if placed in hypertonic solution. Some of the part I covered that is not in your syllabus, so you have to study in the higher classes. I include this because of just getting knowledge. Now some questions. What is the name of organelle that can be called as kitchen of the cell? Explain why it can be called so. Chloroplast is called as the kitchen of the cell. The green plastid are better known as the kitchen of the cell because it contain chlorophyll, which is used in the process of photosynthesis. Through this process, plant cell prepare food, which is ultimately stored in the form of starch. What is the name of the organelle that helps in cell division? The answer is centrosome. What are genes? How are they important to organism? What is its function? Thread-like structures called chromatins are present inside the nucleus. The thread-like structure condenses to form chromosome during cell division. Chromosome contain DNA, and DNA is our hereditary material, and segments of DNA are called genes. Genes contain all the information needed by the cell to function and to reproduce for the cell of next generation. So the genes are responsible for inheritance of characters. The function of genes is to be transfer hereditary information from the parents to the offspring. What are the different functions performed by the cell membrane? It separates cell from each other. It keeps the cell separated from the surrounding external medium. It gives shape and size to the cell. It allows movement of selected substance inside and outside the cell. It provides supports to cell. The next question is, what is cytoplasm? Cytoplasm is the jelly-like substance present between the cell membrane and the nucleus. Various cell organelles of the cells present in the cytoplasm are mitochondria, Golgi bodies, ribosomes, etc. Now the next question, what is the location of the chromosome in a cell? State their function. Chromosomes are found in the nucleus of the cell. They carry genes and help in inheritance of the characters from the parents to the offspring. The function of the chromosomes are, it appears while the cell is ready to divide. Chromosomes play a role in the reproduction of the cell during division of labor. Division of labor means when cell is ready to divide into daughter cell. Everyone write this difference, that is in the page number 132 in your book. The difference between a plant and an animal cell. Plant cell, it has a rigid and non-living cell wall. In animal cell, no such wall is present. It usually has one or two large vacuoles. In animal cell, vacuoles are either absent or are smaller in size. Plastid are present in animals. A plant cell, plastid are absent in animal cell. Centrosomes are absent, centrosomes are present. Ribosomes are absent in plant, ribosomes are present in plant, and everyone can draw these plant cell and animal cell in their copies. Everyone can draw three pictures. One is microscope, second is plant cell, and third is animal cell in their copies. I hope everyone would understand what I taught in this video. If there is any confusion, ask within a class. Maybe this time I will not give the homework as written. Everyone watch this video and write the question answer that I showed in this video.